Why is construction technology important? In this video, I'm going to give you the reasons it's important and talk to you about some technologies which even the small contractors should have. So if you would like to know what are the benefits to you, why should you dig into some of these technologies, and what are the ones that you should already have? And I don't mean should in a negative way. I mean, you deserve to have these things, right? If you want to know that list, you've come to the right place. This is your video. Let's go. All right, so construction technology is a jam. Let me give you a couple of parameters. Construction technology should do what it needs to do so humans can do what they need to do. So if a construction technology is doing things that humans should be doing, we are just, and I'm going to use this term, like not enabling or disabling our construction teams because we're filtering off a key human process to technology. So always make sure whatever tech you use, it's allowing humans to do what they need to do and what they do best. The other thing is construction tech should be useful, addictive, and fast. Useful, addictive, and fast, right? So we do not want something that's going to take extra time. One of the things that I absolutely loathe is tech coming into the construction realm in the form of an application or software, and you're doing it and something that would take us like 1 to 2 to 3 steps by hand, and I know that offends everybody, now it takes 25 clicks on an app or a phone or a tablet. That doesn't help us. That increases the burden. So any software out there should be measured by those standards. But if they are, right, if it is addictive, if it is fast, if it is useful, if it does enable humans to do what they do best, if it reduces the load, then here are your benefits. Number one, improved efficiency. This is a no-brainer. We've been using machines for quite a long time. If there's something in, and actually this is really good. So this topic could be pretty boring, but I don't think we're doing it like that. This is pretty interesting. If from an efficiency standpoint, if you see things human beings are, that human beings are doing things that are taking them a long time and wearing out their bodies and costing you money, could ask yourself, could a machine do that better, right? Instead of cutting those studs, can a machine do that better? Instead of stick framing that wall, can we print them in a prefab yard ahead of time, right? You get my point, right? Instead of manually shooting grade, can we put a GPS unit on this equipment? So tech from that standpoint is absolutely phenomenal. And if you keep it well maintained, it will definitely help improve your efficiency. Number two, cost savings. I love, love, love the quote that I heard a long time ago that said, we do not lose money with tools and equipment. We lose money with lost labor hours, right? And so if there's a piece of equipment or if there's a technology that can save labor hours, by the way, real quick, sidebar, when we talk about this, a lot of times, oh, I remember a LinkedIn post one time where there was an individual inside a computer, like a computer automated screen with computer automated controls that were remote controlling a field excavator. And I remember somebody saying, oh great, now we're gonna be put out of jobs. Let me tell you the truth about this. We don't have enough workers. Right now in the United States, we need at least 500,000 right now. And that number by now and in the future will definitely be much, much larger. In the United States, there's 4 to 5 million people that are able to have jobs, that could have jobs, that don't have jobs, that don't want jobs, right? So all of this nonsense of people taking our jobs, of us not having enough jobs, or tech or AI taking our jobs, it's not a thing. There's plenty to go around. We need to focus more on having supplemented capability and reducing labor hours for wasted work so that human beings, which there aren't enough of right now for today's economy, can go do the myriad of things that only they can do. And so technology is crucial from that standpoint. We've got to stop fighting, arguing, and complaining about not having enough people. And we've got to get less picky about outsourcing. We've got to get less picky about using migrant labor. We've got to get more intelligent when it comes to using equipment and things that robots can do so we can really treasure the human resources, or the human beings, if you don't like resources, the human beings that we have that do critical work for us. Okay, so that's absolutely huge. That's one of the biggest benefits. Three, enhanced safety. This is just a no-brainer. When we look at technology to help, especially human beings, right? We are looking for technology that will reduce motion, help save a person's body, right? Help human beings to be more alert, more aware, focus on the right things, keep us safe. Like what comes into my mind are fall protection or fall arrest systems, right? Anything, oh, even the new hard hat styles, right, that have come out. The old V-Bream, which I loved the way I looked in that, by the way, but I had to get rid of it. To the new, like a brand that I like to use is the Cask, right? The helmets with the flop down visor, right, with the safety glasses. This technology is helping us to get safer and safer and safer. One quick note here. When we talk about tech, especially for those developing technology, you've got to read the book Invisible Women. This talks about the gender data gap when it comes to women and women's studies. In the United States especially, we do not have PPE that are sized for women. And I'm not being inappropriate when I say this. This is a real thing, so I'm gonna bring it out. That PPE and fall protection that are designed to accommodate women's breasts, their hip sizes, their body types, even with handheld tools, a woman's hand size. So one thing that I would say, and for an employer, look for equipment and tech specifically that take care of both men and women, male and female workers. And for developers, people who are inventing these things, we have to make sure that we consider those different body types. But absolutely huge when it comes to a safety standpoint. Number four, better project management. Absolutely fantastic consideration. Number five, there's tech out there that can help you with your quality and the accuracy of the product that you have. There's tech that can help you with how sustainable your construction is on the actual project itself. And the list goes on. The bottom line is there are so many benefits. If you start to look at technology, that means equipment, that means advanced tech, that means applications, that means software, they can help you with your organization. It will pay dividends, not only in the blessing and the safety of your people, but also for your profit. So here's what I recommend. By the way, I started strong and then basically the list goes on so far for the benefits that I'm gonna leave it to this. If you identify and discuss and solve the problems that are facing your business, you're often going to find technology that can fill the gaps. I'd rather spend the rest of the time here going through some of the things that we should be doing right now already. All right, number one, building information modeling. This is a gem. I thought this was a given. It's not. Not all projects do it. Now, if you're doing a multifamily project, maybe you don't need it. But building information modeling allows you to do a myriad of things when it comes to the modeling and the modeling of actual information data within the actual design itself and that 3D geometry that will help you. I'm talking about, obviously, exterior renderings, right? Isometric drawings, axonometric views of zones for project scheduling, 3D coordination, interfaces when it comes to critical details. I could just keep going on and on and on. Every construction company should have either in-house BIM capabilities or have an outsourced entity that can do those BIM tasks on an as-needed basis. Number two, drones. We are in the experiment phase with this, but I'm telling you, drones can be absolutely fantastic when it comes, even for some of the simple things like job site photos, job site documentation, project walks, inspections on the exterior facade. Everything about this video, I could just go on for like hundreds of items, but I'm gonna have to cut it short. I encourage you as a company to start looking at how drones can help you and your project team manage your project to really increase the capacity of the project team and to create a better quality product. Number three, 3D printing. I love it. I literally went to a project in Virginia just the other day. They had the entire building 3D printed. You could take off the floor. You could see the zone maps. Foreman are pointing at it, talking to it. 3D printing is a jam. We have got to do it. I would love to see trade partner offices or your last planner offices where you had two tables and in the middle is a huge 3D printed model of the actual structure so that we can actually use it for planning and visualization. 3D printing. Four, prefabrication and modular construction. Literally last week, I was in one of those facilities. I won't tell you who it is, but absolutely fantastic company. They print walls and pods. They will definitely help your project if they pencil out. Much safer, workers are in much better conditions. It's absolutely fantastic. Virtual reality and augmented reality. I have lots of stories here. I don't know why, but literally 3 weeks ago, I was taken through a hospital where they paid money to have these individual rooms, right? The exam rooms or the imaging rooms modeled and rendered beautifully so that when you put on the headset, the end users could literally touch and feel and experience, you know, within reason. Probably more like look and get a feel for the space so that they knew it was right before they began construction. Fantastic. And if you can't do it in-house, there are companies, and I'll help you out to get you connected, that will help you with these if you need it. There's also other technology when it comes to project management. You're probably familiar there. There's wearable technology that will literally help you from a personal protective equipment standpoint. There's robotics and automation already available on construction sites. Better tools and tech that we can use that helps with ergonomics and the motions that human beings have to go through to lift and carry materials. There's smart materials, construction analytics, and the list goes on and on and on and on. But the bottom line is, oh, here, so you don't think this is just some random video where Jason's rambling. I'm not, stop it. But literally what I'm talking to you about is, please IDS, identify, discuss, and solve your issues, and then see if there's technology that can help you fill those gaps. All you have to do is type in a quick Google search or go on to ChatGPT or contact me. I've got a large network of people. I can ask the question really quickly and probably get you what you need. But the bottom line is, if you have a need, there's probably some technology that can help you out, and most of it probably pencils out. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. I'm going to put this into a blog post below to help you. And if you ever need help, contact me directly. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.